And it came to pass in those days that it came, that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius, the governor of Syria, was the governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, everyone to his own city. And Joseph, also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for him in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. Shepherds over there. I like your sheep, shepherds. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them and jumped on the fireplace. And the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. Twice. And the angel said unto them, "Fear not. For behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be unto all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace, goodwill toward men."
Mary, value the baby more than the sheep.
Take care of the baby.
Joseph,
let go of the sheep.
I thought that was a donkey.
Sheep, dog, donkey, sheep, donkey.
And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now, go even unto Bethlehem, and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us." And they came with haste, and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in the manger.
Oh, hey, look at here.
And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all they that heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen as it was told unto them. And then we're turning to chapter 2 of Matthew, where we talk about the wise men. Now, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judah in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, oh, you can be the king, Todd. Todd's going to be the king. Where is he that is born, king of the Jews?
Over here, flute.
For we have seen his star in the east, and are come to worship him. When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, 'And thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, art not the least among the princes of Judah, for out of thee shall come a great governor that shall rule my people Israel.'" Then Herod, when he had privily called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the young child. And when ye have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also." When they had heard the king, they departed. And lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts. Here, get the baby Jesus gifts. Gold and frankincense and myrrh. And being warned of God in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country another way. And when they were departed, depart into your own country another way. Thank you. And when they were departed, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream. Go to sleep, Joseph. Angel, we need you.
Oh, we need the angel.
The angel's coming and is about to appear to Joseph in a dream, saying, arise.
Okay. Arise.
And take the young child and his mother and flee into Egypt and be thou there until I bring thee word. For Herod will seek the young child to destroy him. When he arose, he took the young child and his mother by night and departed into Egypt. Then Herod slew all the children that were in Bethlehem and in all the coasts thereof from 2 years old and under, according to the time which he had diligently inquired of the wise men. You're a star, Todd.
All right. That's the French version where we have to end on, then Herod slew all the children. Special thanks to our narrator, Miss Bethany.
Hi.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.